Hey everyone, this is another HubSpot video blog or vlog, which is super cool to say. We're going to talk a little bit today about the HubSpot keyword tool because we found it very helpful in selecting keywords for our blogs and being able to track a lot of things. So I'm going to take you into our portal. We recently just kind of cleaned out a lot of keywords, so you're not going to see a ton of stuff in it or any very secret intelligence, but I did want to share it with you. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. We can talk a little bit about what we're going to be sharing here today. So if I go in here and I'm going to go over to HubSpot, I'm just going to go into the marketing section so you can see how to get here. So if you go ahead and go to general marketing, then you go to reports, you can click on keywords. So this is if you have the marketing section of HubSpot. And inside here, it'll start telling you what keywords are ranking. Now, the cool thing is you can add your keywords. So if you had a site done by our sister company, Agency Appeal, we supply those. Or if you use another vendor, which shame on you, but I understand they exist, you can also go ahead and ask them for a list of keywords. And these are kind of your core keywords that are based on your site. And so there's two different types of keywords today. There's your site keywords, and then there's also keywords that you're going to use and optimize in your blog. So like auto insurance, Massachusetts might be a keyword on your website, but that not might be something that you're trying to rank on your blog. You might be trying to rank on your blog of uninsured motorists, something a little bit smaller. So this will start tracking all of your keywords. So it goes through number of monthly searches, how many visits, the difficulty of the keyword, the estimated cost per click if you're going to run AdWords, and if it's associated to any campaigns. But the real thing I want to show you guys here is if you click add keywords, you can get suggestions. So I was writing a blog today about increasing retention inside of agencies. So I typed in here insurance retention. And it's going to give me some suggestions about the keywords I might actually want to use in my blog based on research, not just sort of guessing, which is kind of cool. So you can take a look here. What is insurance retention? All of these fun words. Now, the one thing that you want to make sure of is that you actually go Google it, because sometimes what's coming up is not your intent. So when I was doing this, I was coming up with retention sort of like, you know, almost like there's a missing coverage as opposed to what we're talking about, which is retaining customers. So I just go over here, quickly hop into Google, find out what's ranking, you know, and then you can kind of see, well, there's some different things on here as far as terms, et cetera, but I'm still going to go for it and use this as a keyword. So once I do that, I can select this, and then I can click Use Selected, and it'll add the keywords to my dashboard. So now I can kind of see which keywords we're hitting for, but more importantly, we can see what we're ranking for. So my team, Danielle and my team, has an option. We want to try to get one keyword in the top three. So like I said, we just redid our keyword strategy, so we're trying to build that up. And her goal is one of the top three over the course of the first month. So you can kind of set your marketing strategy goals from here too. So just another little tip on how to find keywords by using HubSpot. Thanks everybody. I hope you have a great day.